responsibility when congratulating the school today and remain at the level one throughout the assembly. Please show your appreciation appropriately with applause only, as this is a formal occasion. Thank you to our senior band for your wonderful performance this morning as we entered this assembly. We would like to welcome our special guests here today, who include, please stand quietly. Principal of Golden Hills North Public School, Mr. Graham Cohn. Ms. Deputy Principal, Mrs. Sue Taylor. President of the PFD, Mrs. Laura Halliday. Honourable David Elliott, Member for Fulham Hills. Councillor Rosemary Bonham, Councillor Hill City Council. Mr. Ostrowski and Mrs. Alice Pullen, Scrabble Writing Club. Mrs. Kay Annie, Vonta Club. Mrs. Beth Tambor, Mrs. Susan Z, and Dr. Jordan Neely. Please be seated.
Good morning, teachers, special guests, students, and our wonderful parents. Welcome to the 2022 Fulham Hills North Public School Stage 3 Presentation Day Assembly. Today, students in years 5 and 6 are being recognized for their academic, sporting, and creative achievements, as well as their leadership and friendship. Please stand quietly for the National Anthem and the Acknowledgement. We would like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land, the Bidjigal people on which this assembly takes place. We also pay our respects to the elders, past and present, and those of the future. We would like to also pay our respects to other Aboriginal people here today. We must also remember that under these buildings and under this asphalt lies what was, is, and always will be Aboriginal land. Please remain standing for the National Anthem.
I would now like to invite Mr. Holmes to officially welcome us to our presentation day.
and Sam. So good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Baulkham Hills North Public School 2022 Presentation Day Assembly. It is with great pride that I stand before you as the principal of our wonderful school, and to be able to recognise the achievements and efforts of our students today. Every day, I feel extremely grateful to be the principal of this outstanding school, to have the opportunity to lead our school and to work closely with our students, our teachers and our families. It's an absolute honour and a privilege. I welcome and thank our special guests, our parents, teachers and of course the students for your attendance today. It feels so good to be back together as a community. It is indeed terrific to be able to conduct this assembly in its traditional form, not having done so since 2019. So doing it after 2 years of interruption created by the wretched COVID-19 virus. This year, and with our extended lockdowns, or having to return to home learning, we've been able to fully deliver a very extensive range of activities and opportunities our school so generously offers. Even with the COVID spectre being continuously present, we have managed to deliver some wonderful events and celebrations over the years. These have included our swimming carnival, our events carnival, our cross country, we've held NAIOP week celebrations, we've delivered the kinder orientation programs, students have represented our school at national, state, zone and regional levels of sport and in other cultural activities such as the Premier Spelling Bee. We've strengthened our relationships with our corporate partners such as Microsoft and HP Australia. We celebrated Literacy Lovers Day. We held our annual book fair. We visited Canberra, Milson Island and Toronto Zoo, where our Year 4s got up close and personal, sleeping with the zoo inhabitants. And we hosted numerous fundraisers for very worthy causes. We also have opened the Dr. Jordan Wen Innovation Centre during our Innovation Symposium only last month, with our innovation program quickly becoming the personal signature of the school. And we still have our upcoming Year 6 graduation on Friday and our whole school party day. So I'd say it's fair to say that we got the school back on track very quickly, shrugging off the last 2 years of disruption to the school operations. But while these things were achieved, it is not to say that we didn't have our challenges, as we knew that after 2 years of COVID impacted learning, we had to get you, the students, back on track and address any impact caused by the disruption that COVID created. For some of our younger students, Year 1 and Year 2, 2022 was their first full year of uninterrupted learning. Students, your teachers took this challenge very seriously and they worked hard to identify and address any gaps in your learning and supported you to re-engage, to refocus, to catch up and to be successful. I'm so proud of the teachers and how they lifted your spirits and ensured that you had the best year of learning ever. I'm also so proud of you, as you all rose to the challenges you faced and worked hard to overcome any difficulties you may have encountered. I am so pleased to report that our students are back on track with their learning and our performance data in literacy and numeracy is showing significant growth in learning levels and confirming that our students are back to where they're expected to be in their respective stages of learning at this time. In doing this, we have discovered a depth of resilience, compassion and togetherness that has shone through and the never say die attitude of our school community. I'd like to take this opportunity to pay my deepest thanks, firstly to our amazing teachers, the executive staff, the senior executive staff and the support staff of the school. I am constantly in awe of the teamwork, the passion and the drive to support our students through what have been very, very challenging times. Each week I observe the hours of work, the deep level of care and commitment and the passion and drive our staff give to supporting our students and providing them the very best learning experiences each and every day. They have an unwavering dedication to continuing improving learning and wellbeing outcomes for all our students. For what has been an exceptional few years, I want to say thank you to our staff for all you have done and what you continue to do, and to ensure every student is successful at our school and that they are known, they're valued and that they are cared for. My most sincere thanks. To our incredible community, without you, the parents, carers and families, we would not have been able to support our students with the same level of success. Your trust, your support, and your dedication are highly valued, and the close relationships we have with all of you strengthens our learning partnership and is making a real difference to student learning outcomes. We are very thankful for your resolute approach in ensuring your children have kept learning during these recent challenging times. A sincere thank you. So while acknowledging the work of our community, I can't go past the excellent support and commitment demonstrated by our PNC. The core group within the PNC, including the executive and many members, did not miss a meeting this year. They continue to advocate for our students and found ways to creatively engage and raise funds for our school. The success of Carols on Saturday night was amazing, held last Saturday evening. The colour run in term three, the Mother's and Father's Day stalls, the Election Day barbecues, the school discos, the cake stalls and the carnivals, and the successful completion of the senior playground is a testament to the strength of the PNC and their impressive commitment to Walker Hill Public School. So to Ms. Laura Halliday, who's here as a special guest, and the whole PNC team, a big thank you for all your support for 2022. And I think we'll give them a round of applause. Thank you. I'd also like to thank our amazing volunteers for all their help over the year, the sort of quiet achievers of the school. Whether it be in the classrooms, helping at sporting events, flipping sausages on the barbecue, or sleeping over at Zeus News, I'm not sure there was much sleeping, but they were certainly there. Our school is a better place because of you. But there was one volunteer that I wish to single out and thank enormously, and that's Mrs. Olivia Lee, our uniform shop coordinator. The school's conducted a PNC-operated uniform shop for many, many years, probably since the school commenced. And since 2011, Mrs. Lee has led and coordinated the service to excel on a voluntary basis, hours and hours of work each week, as well as working full time. So over the last 11 years, Olivia provided amazing service to our school community, but this year the decision was taken to outsource the service, and it is now being operated by Lowe's and Pastor Towers. Miss Lee could not be with us here today because she had work commitments. But I wanted you to know that the dedication, the hard work and commitment of Olivia and her band of volunteers ensured that our children were able to wear their full school uniform with pride each and every day, and they're doing that here today. So please join me in thanking Olivia. Students. I've loved being with you again this year. You really are a wonderful group of students with so many unique and special strengths. I can recall countless times where I've witnessed students helping a friend in need, being a buddy for kindergarten students, demonstrating empathy and compassion for one another. You have all shown great strength and character and true resilience this year. I'm so proud of you, as you all rose to the challenges you have faced and worked hard to overcome any difficulties you have encountered. You're an absolute delight to work with, and I know being amongst you every day enriches me as a person and keeps me young at heart. I would like to acknowledge all the students receiving awards today. Congratulations. Success and reward is not something we simply stumble upon by accident. It's only achieved through persistence, courage, kindness and hard work. Success, as it is said, comes from 99% perspiration and 1% inspiration. Today is about recognising and celebrating those efforts in their various forms. Congratulations on your successes this year. To our current school captains and our student leaders, I would like to say thank you for all your excellent work in preparing and delivering today's presentation assembly. I've thoroughly enjoyed working with all this year and you've done a wonderful job in your roles. You've led the way in adapting to challenging times. You've demonstrated awesome confidence and professionalism in running the weekly assemblies and with the aid of technology creating and sharing our virtual assemblies. Your leadership of the student parliament has seen a flourish in 2022 and has become a real and authentic voice for the student body. So your leadership, dedication and support for our school is greatly valued and greatly appreciated. So many thanks for your work this year. Thank you, Catherine. So I'd like to finish off by saying how I am proud of everyone's achievements this year. Whether you're receiving an award today or not, you've all grown, you've all improved, you've taken steps forward and you've worked hard to achieve your goals. I want us all to look back on 2022 and think about all we've gained through our tenacity, our strong spirit and strength as a quality school. We've overcome great adversity from the last 2 years. We've demonstrated flexible, innovative and creative thinking skills, and you have found new levels of resilience and grit, which you didn't know you had. There's no challenge too big that we can't take on when we all work together. Before I say final farewell, there's some special farewells that I would like to acknowledge. Ms. Kristen Packer, Ms. Miranda Lee and Mrs. Tanya Villalonco will be finishing at our school at the end of this year and will be taking up teaching appointments at Windsor South, Castle Hill and North Kellyville Public Schools respectively in 2023. During their time here, they have inspired countless students, and through their dedication, expertise and care, they have touched the lives of many. They are outstanding educators and will be deeply missed by all of us here at Fort Macquarie Public School. We wish them every happiness and future success in their new roles. Again, please join me in thanking them for their exceptional work. Her team have helped us with the organisation of today's assemblies. Delivering an assembly of this kind is no mean feat, and I've seen the hours of work undertaken by Amanda and her team over several weeks to put today's program together, organising all the prizes and the awards for the students. A massive help, Ms. Carter, which you've done so well. It is much appreciated by all. Thank you. We'll give her a round of applause. Staff and families, I wish you a safe and happy Christmas and summer break. This is the year to continue practicing gratitude for what we have and for who we are, and I look forward to seeing you all for a wonderful year ahead in 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Holmes. I would like to invite Mrs. Smith and the Year 5 teachers, Mrs. Bolton, Mrs. Mamet, Ms. Lai, Mrs. McKay, and Mrs. Purvis to present their class awards. Please reserve your applause until all students have been named. Read Mrs. Smith, who is the class.
It is my privilege today to announce the awards for Year 5. 5B, for Outstanding Academic Achievement in English, Zaina Ali. 8 Chin. The Citizenship Moment Fund. And for Outstanding Effort, Evelyn Arthur. The Citizenship, Amber Dawson. For Outstanding Effort, Bianca Pye. G for outstanding academic achievement in English, Daniel Zhang. For outstanding academic achievement in mathematics, here at Moon. For citizenship, Rosemary Honker. For outstanding effort, Rashida Das. For outstanding academic achievement in English, Jessica Yap. For outstanding academic achievement in mathematics, Samuel Zhao. For citizenship, Charlotte Leeds. And for outstanding effort, Devayan Naidu. For outstanding academic achievement in English, Faris Saqib Akbar. For outstanding academic achievement in mathematics, Maitri Terry. Citizenship, Thomas Harrison. And outstanding effort, Isabel Lim. Please help me congratulate the Year 5 award.
Congratulations to all the Year 5 award recipients. Thank you, Mrs. Smith, Ms. Carter, and the Year 5 teachers.
I would like to invite Mrs. Mashaya and Mr. Elliott to present the Library Award. My immense pleasure to announce the awardees for the Library Award for this year. This year, I will be awarding two Stage 3 Library Awards. The two recipients of this award have been diligent library monitors throughout the whole year. They regularly attend library for duties 3, 4, or 5 days a week and always brighten the room with their smiles. There is no task these students were unwilling to do, including the endless task of sharpening pencils for kindy. They often ran our weekly dance lunchtime sessions and implemented rules to assist it to run smoothly. Also, for kindy. They were experts at shelving books and diligently worked until all books were returned and shelved. Their contribution this year to the library has been exemplary. It is my great pleasure to award this year's Stage 3 Library Awards to Flynn Stanley and Liam Byron.
Thank you, Mrs. Mashaya and Mr. Elliott. We would now like to invite our PNC president, Ms. Laura Halliday, to talk to us about our wonderful PNC. Thank you, Mrs. Mashaya.
Congratulations. This is it. Another year is nearly at a close. You've grown, you've thrived, and you've created more memories of your time here at Borkenfoss North Public School. It's been a year filled with uncertainty and flexibility, but here you are today celebrating our school community, and more importantly, we're all celebrating you. We are extremely fortunate to live in such a generous community who make Borkenfoss North events and fundraisers a success. And in preparation for today, it got me wondering, what is your special memory? Is it busting a move or dressing up at the disco? Or maybe being sprayed by all the colours of the rainbow as you made your way through the colour run course? Was it picking out a treasured gift for the Mother's Day or Father's Day stall? I know I like my pink back scratcher, especially. Or getting up on stage at the carols to belt out a song or perform a dance. Could it have been picking out a delicious treat from the baking stalls or barbecues? What about the time you spent at lunch or recess playing on the new play equipment? Whatever your special memory, I'm proud to say that the PNC was part of creating it. And I'd like to recognise today some very special people who worked tirelessly through the year to be Magic Moment creators. Thank you to the PNC executive, Alison Mackey, Candice Nilsson, Karen Azaias, David Hood, who's here taking photos today and manages to capture all the memories so we have them for a lifetime, Dion White, Marty Lucas, Olivia Lee, Laura Gisellis, and Maria Garriga. Thank you to our Mother's Day and Father's Day and disco organisers, Lucy, Jade and Michelle, to Lee and all the families who worked on the recent carols, and to all of the parents who volunteered, baked barbecued, or served at any of the events that we have throughout the year. I'd like to echo Mr. Holmes and pass on a huge thank you to Mrs. Olivia Lee for her many years as uniform shop coordinator, and to the many, many, many volunteers who have enabled us to offer this service within our community for so long before we closed the doors on the uniform shop this year. Thank you to Mr. Holmes, Mrs. Taylor, Miss Carter, Angie Davidson, the office team, and all of the teachers here at Baulkham Hills North for everything you do to support our children every day. The PNC could not achieve everything that we have this year without you. And finally, thank you to you, the students at Baulkham Hills North. Keep working hard and creating memories together. Carry them with you and treasure these moments. All the best to Year 6 for their transition into high school. And to everyone else, see you next year. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Halliday. I would like to invite Mrs. Armstrong and Ms. Carter to present the Stage 3 Performing Arts Award for 2022. Led by Mrs. Armstrong, presented by Ms. Carter.
Thank you, Mrs. Halliday. The Stage 3 Performing Arts Award, male, is an enthusiastic and diligent member of the Stage 3 choir, dance and drama groups. His love of singing, drama and dance have developed over his time at Baulkham Hills North through his commitment to the performing arts groups since Stage 1. The very deserving winner of the Stage 3 Performing Arts Award is Ryan Basil. Dedication and diligence in the performing arts across her schooling. This year alone, she has participated in Stage 3 Drama, the School Spectacular Choir, Stage 3 Choir, Stage 3 Dance, and the School Band. I am pleased to present the Stage 3 Creative and Performing Arts Award to Ella Tuhikawa.
And Ms. Carr. We would now like to invite Mrs. Taylor to present the Senior Band Award for 2022 on behalf of Mrs. Lucia Pichar, read and presented by Mrs. Taylor.
Just before I present this award to one of our wonderful students, I do want to recognise the Teaching Services Australia staff who train our beginner, intermediate and senior bands that together comprise 120 students at our school. They have had significant challenges through the pandemic period, but I think you heard this morning the fruits of their efforts as you listened to the senior band perform before this assembly began. So I would like to recognise their efforts with a round of applause. The Senior Band Award for Stage 3 is presented to a student who has continued to grow musically throughout primary school. This student has remained diligent and enthusiastic towards their musical development and is a talented and enthusiastic musician. I am delighted to present the Senior Band Award for 2022 to Uzair Abdullah.
Thank you, Mrs. Taylor. The Strings Ensemble will now play an item for us, the Nutcracker Suite, March and Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairy by P.I. Tchaikovsky. Thank you.
Thank you, Strings Ensemble, for your outstanding performance. The audience loved hearing you play today. We would now like to invite Mr. Gardner and Mrs. Kemp to present the Sporting Award for the year, beginning with the Premier Sporting Challenge for 2023.
Values of a fair team player at all times. This student consistently strives to improve their sporting skill through practice and determination and supports their teammates at all times. This year's winner of the Premier Sporting Challenge Medal is an outstanding student and a great role model for younger students. He displays excellent leadership qualities which translate onto the sporting field. During his time at Auckland Hills North Public School, he has represented the school at swimming, athletics, and in PWZ through both rugby league and touch football, as well as at the basketball gala day. His skills and teamwork contributed to his selection in the 2022 Castle Hill PWZ rugby league team. Away from representative sport, he is always willing to help other students who may require assistance in learning a new skill and tailors his competitiveness to the situation and ability of those around him. This student epitomises the Premier Sporting Challenge Medal. I'm incredibly pleased and proud to award the 2022 Premier Sporting Challenge Medal today to Blake Dodd. Mr. Gardner and Mrs. Kemp will now present the sporting trophies. Present the certificates for the records broken by our athletes this year and present the Barry Wheeler Trophy to our outstanding athletes.
It gives me great pleasure to announce the sporting champions for 2022. The recipients of these trophies are all in Stage 3. The Junior Girls Swimming and the Junior Athletics Champions will be presented with their trophy at the Stage 2 assembly. Swimming. Junior Boys Champion is Cameron Bailey. It's Justine Bashkan Mugabadel. For 2022, Junior Boys, Cameron Bates. Grace Gant. Our 11-year boys is Nishad Pandit. Our 11-year girls is Lucy Sherwood. Our senior boys is Ethan Warnock. And our senior girls are very happy and powerful.
Each year we collect the house points at the swimming, cross country and athletics carnivals, and we're going to find out which teams won which carnival. So, as I call these teams out from the house, leaders and captains come up to collect the shield. The winning house for swimming this year was Oak. Was Wattle. And so, as I mentioned before, we've collated all the points across all three carnivals. And if you turn your attention to our display board, once it wakes up, there are our final standings for the year. Well done, Wattle. Now, at all our carnivals, we always acknowledge any school records that have been broken. In 2022, we have three new records that have been set. When you hear your name, please come to the stage to receive your certificate for your broken record. So to start off with, in swimming, we had one record broken. Ethan Saunders, he's now set a new 11 years boys 50 metre backstroke record at 37.65 seconds. Two records broken at athletics. Cameron Beatty broke the junior boys 800 record with a time of 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Okay. And the last record broken was by Lucy Sherwood for the 11 years girls 800 metres. we're about to hand out the Barry Wheeler Award or Trophy. Now, this trophy is awarded to the top boy and girl student from across all the schools in the Castle Hill PLSA. This student is being recognised for their outstanding achievements in representative sport. This student from Hawking Hills North has tied with three other students on 22 points. They've represented Hawking Hills North, Castle Hill PLSA, Sydney West in several sports, including swimming, cross country, athletics, touch football, and soccer. The Castle Hill PLSA female Barry Wheeler recipient for 2022 is Lucy Sherwood.
Thank you, Mr. Gardner and Mrs. Kemp. I would like to invite Mr. Gardner, Mrs. Kemp, and Mrs. Taylor to present the Field Family Sportsmanship Awards on behalf of the Field Family. Read by Mrs. Kemp and Mrs. Gardner, presented by Mrs. Taylor.
The female recipient of this award is an outstanding student who always displays and upholds our school core values. She is an exemplary role model of sportsmanship. She has achieved excellence in a range of sporting arenas, including representing the school at athletics, cross country, at the zone, regional and state levels. This student is an inspiration to others for the effort she applies to all her sporting activities. She has represented our school in PLSA netball and touch football throughout her primary school years. She has been a member of the Castleville PLSA Zone Touch Football teams and has represented Sydney West in touch football. Her sportsmanship and friendly nature have made her an exceptional Oak House captain who is highly deserving of this award. The Female Field Family Sportsmanship Award for 2022 goes to Eva McKenzie.
The male recipient of the Field Family Sportsmanship Award has demonstrated outstanding sportsmanship in all levels of the sport that he participates in, which is an admirable quality for any athlete. This student has represented Hawking Hills North Public School in PWSA, the T-ball, softball and Newcomb ball, as well as being selected into the Castle Hill Zone softball team. He has represented our school at both cross country and athletics, competing at the Sydney West level for athletics. Even though he is shy, sport brings out the best in him, transforming him into a confident young man. His honest and friendly nature have made him approachable to younger athletes, and his determination has been admired by all. This student is a very deserving recipient of this award. The male Field Family Sportsmanship Award for 2022 goes to Ethan Watt.
Thank you, Mrs. Kemp, Mr. Gardner, and Mrs. Taylor. I would like to invite Ms. Carter, Mr. Gardner, and Mr. Kemp to present their outgoing House leaders with their recognition for the members.
I would like to thank our
2022 House Captains and Leaders for their hard work, encouragement and leadership of their respective houses. We're going to begin with our CEDA leaders, Ivy Ella, Ellie Forbes, Harrison Nolan, Max Sheether, and our captains for CEDA, Noah Baker and Poppy Smith. Blake Donnelly, Victoria Kedzia, Sarah Manane, Lola White, and our captains, Summer Davison and Matthew Swan. Tubi Carver, and our captains, Amir, Margaret, Lavani, and Eva McKenzie. And our roster leadership team, Elizabeth Cordo, Lachlan Jack, Eva King, Nathaniel Pullman-Hood, and our captains of Wattle, Zara Cativo-Palomo, and Marcus Capullo.
Thank you, Ms. Potter and Mrs. Kemp and Mr. Gardner. I'd like to invite Mr. Gardner and Mrs. Kemp to announce the House Leaders and Captains for 2023.
Into their roles and receive their badges. But for today, I'm just going to introduce them. So they're just going to stay where they are, but we can find out who the different leaders are for the various houses. In 2023, each house will have 6 sports leaders and 2 of the students being the captains. Congratulations to the following students for being elected as house leaders for 2023. Well, they are coming up on the league. We'll get your badges next year. Alrighty. Totally know what's up. Alright, Peter, Charlie Hadlow, Tom Harrison, Leah Karen, Harrison Phillips, Lily Sipkus, and Stuart Thompson. Can we hold our applause at the end? Thank you. they'll get that back to that assembly next year. Paul Gum, Christian Alcusis, Cameron Beatty, Daisy Grant, Martina Hans-Grigger, Owen Hobart, Bianca Pye. For Oak, Max Brunston, Emma Buckley, Luna Hickman, Charlotte McCaggy, Dion Rampside, and Luke Warbury. And for Wattle, Oscar Armitage, Hayden Cho, Rachel Davidson, Lauren Hack, Jesse Millay, Savannah Romero Wilson. Now the house captains for each house of 2023 will be Casita. It's Thomas Harrison and Leah Perrin. For Gum, Cameron Beatty and Martina Hams-Garriga. For Oak, Max Brunston and Emma Buckley. And for Wattle, Rachel Davidson and Jesse Millay.
Thank you, Mrs. Campbell, Mr. Gardner. I would like to invite Mrs. Sugiana to the stage, along with the music teachers, Mrs. Berger, Ms. Houston, Mrs. Kemp, and Mr. Gardner, who have their top awards. Please reserve your applause until all award winners have been announced. Read by Mrs. Sugiana.
To announce the awards for Year 6. For 6E, Eugene Kim for Academic Achievement in English. Hayley Yun for Academic Achievement in Mathematics. Evelina Alisov for outstanding effort. Elizabeth Cordo for Academic Achievement in English. Andy Nurki for Academic Achievement in Mathematics. Effort. Sophia Winters for academic achievement in English. Max Zhang for academic achievement in mathematics. Andrea C for citizenship. No, I'm going to vary for Ivy Ellen for academic achievement in English. Sabia for academic achievement in mathematics.
Congratulations to all the Year 6 Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Carter, Mrs. Sapiana, and the Year 6 teachers. We would now welcome to the stage the Stage 3 Choir to perform the song See the Lights by Rachel Kelly. They will be conducted by Mrs. Armstrong. Thank you.
Thank you, Stage 3 Choir, for your wonderful performance. We would like to invite Mr. Holmes and Councillor Rosemary Grimmon from the Hillshire Council to present the Hillshire Council School Citizenship Award.
Hillshire Council Citizenship Award is presented to a student who has displayed outstanding citizenship throughout their time at Portland Rosemont Public School. This year, the award is presented to a student who consistently displays his school's core values and represents Portland Rosemont with pride at many school events. Her commitment to improving school life for other students makes her a truly deserving recipient of this award. Throughout her time at Portland Hills North, this student has shown outstanding citizenship and leadership skills as a library monitor and kindergarten buddy. Her commitment to the school is evident through her participation in sporting and creative and performing arts events. She displays a growth mindset at all times and is kind to all those she meets. She has demonstrated leadership across the school by launching the Take 3 for the Sea initiative and has been an active, positive, respectful leader as vice-captain. The Hillshire Council Citizenship Award is presented to Jackie Bashkin.
Thank you, Mr. Holmes and Councillor Bowman. We would like to invite Mr. Holmes and Mrs. Tambor to present the John McGinn's Memorial Award for All Around Achievement. Read by Mr. Holmes, presented by Mrs. Tambor.
John McGinnis Memorial Award is presented in memory of John McGinnis, former principal of Portland Hills North Public School. The award recognises the achievements of a student who demonstrates all-round achievement in school activities. This year's recipient is considered by his peers and teachers to be a thoughtful, hard-working student who consistently displays the school's core values and is held in very high esteem by all those who know him. He has actively participated in school life through his commitment to sport, representing our school at Zone Athletics and PWSA Soccer and Cricket, and as a finalist in the Hills Network Public Speaking Competition. Throughout his time at Portland Hills North, this student has also demonstrated outstanding leadership skills, supporting those around him at all times and leading by example. As part of the current Year 6 leadership team, he has shown a commitment to his school, his education and his community. The John McGinnis Memorial Award for All-Round Achievement is Azhar Abdullah.
Thank you, Mr. Holmes and Mrs. Tambor. I would like to invite Mr. O'Christy and Mrs. Fuller to present the Scrabble Club State for Creative Writing Award. Thank you.
Club Creative Writing Award is presented to a student who shows a passion and flair for creative writing. The student receiving this award today writes wonderfully imaginative texts that reflect her creativity and deep understanding of the way language is used to hold a reader's attention and to draw them into the story. Her short story for the Rotary Club Creative Writing Competition demonstrated her flair for building suspense into her imaginative texts. She also consistently strives to improve her writing by building on feedback from her teachers. The Scrabble Club Creative Writing Award, now known as the Alice Pullen Shield, is presented to Poppy Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Ostrowski and Mrs. Pollen. I would now like to invite Mrs. Ames and Mrs. Pashai to present the Zonta Award for the Most Improved Female Student in Year 5 Science. Read by Mrs. Pashai, presented by Mrs. Ames.
Zonta was established almost 100 years ago. It is a leading global organisation making a difference in the lives of young girls and women through service and advocacy. Members of the Zonta Club of Sydney Hills volunteer their time and talents, fundraising to support and encourage young girls in STEM subjects, science, technology, engineering, medicine and mathematics. Subjects that will, in the future, be increasingly necessary to obtain good jobs, careers, and entry into university. This Zonta Award is to recognise a female student's efforts and potential in these important subjects. This student's application and dedication to inquiry learning in the areas of science, technology, and mathematics this year has been admirable. She consistently asks questions and seeks out solutions. She perseveres in creating solutions to real-world problems, taking into consideration the feedback and opinions of others. In addition, she has been a conscientious and outstanding member of the Maths Olympiad team and was awarded the Special Achievement Award as the highest scoring student in Year 5. Zonta congratulates this year's winner and wishes her every success in the pursuit of her educational goals. The recipient of the 2022 Zonta Award is Maitri Terry.
Thank you, Mrs. Mashaya and Mrs. Ames. We'd like to invite Mrs. Lucas and Mrs. B to present the Quantum Leap in Learning Award.
I'm very excited to present the Quantum Leap Award. The recipient of this award is a student who, in his time at Thornton Hills North Public School, has made positive gains in literacy, numeracy, and his overall attitude. He has embraced challenges with a new resilience this year, accepted help and support with respect and gratitude. With the support of teachers and programs at school, combined with his growing positive attitude, he has gained confidence and shown significant improvement, particularly in spelling and numeracy. He has been an enthusiastic and very helpful member of the Gardening Sustainability Project, which is supporting his literacy skills. He has shown that learning from mistakes and having a growth mindset can have a significant impact not only on learning but also on how to approach his school life. It gives me great pleasure to present the Quantum Leap Award for 2022 to Arne Tamoyan.
Thank you, Mrs. Lucas and Mrs. C. We would like to invite Mrs. Mashiach and Dr. Jordan Ewan to the stage to present the inaugural Dr. Jordan Ewan Award for Innovation, read by Mrs. Mashiach, presented by Dr. Jordan Ewan.
This year's, and inaugural, Dr. Jordan Ewan Innovation Award is presented to a student who has shown an amazing improvement in innovation subjects this year. During the year, this student has used the UN Sustainable Development Goals to research a problem in the real world. She has asked questions of teachers and peers to improve her ideas and used digital technologies to record and construct a semi-working model. This model used the biomimicry of a mangrove forest to capture and remove rubbish from waterways. She has shown diligence and perseverance in learning new skills and used digital applications to enhance her learning. We know she will continue to grow her ideas and make the world around her a much better place. It is with my great pleasure to award this inaugural Dr. Jordan Ewan Innovation Award to Simone.
Thank you.
The Award of Ducks is the highest academic accolade our school can confer upon its students. The award recognises the student as an outstanding scholar in all fields of learning in Year 6. Students who have attained this level of academic achievement have demonstrated a genuine love of learning, have committed themselves fully to work to the best of their ability in each learning task, and have consistently produced work of an exceptional standard. This year, we'll be recognising a student who excels in all areas of English and mathematics. This student consistently attains outstanding results in mathematics and is a skilled member of the Maths Olympiad team. They display excellent reading comprehension skills and creatively play with word choice when constructing written pieces. Their classwork is always completed to an exemplary standard, and their skills in English and mathematics are exceptional. This student is highly dedicated to their education, actively participating in school life at all times, and is leading by example. This student is an outstanding role model for their peers in the way that she approaches all learning tasks with a positive growth mindset and eagerness to achieve the highest possible standard. Achieving the award of Auckland Hills North Public Schools Ducks for 2022 is Elizabeth Hale.
Thank you, Mr. Holmes. With Mr. Holmes, Ms. Carter, and the 2022 school leaders, please come to the stage for the presentation of the letters of appreciation.
Mr. Holmes and I would like to acknowledge our current 2022 school leaders. They have continually displayed our school's core values throughout the year and have carried out their roles with dignity and pride. Our prefects for 2022, Scarlett Lascarides, Caitlin Yee, Poppy Lascarides, Hannah Philippe, Zara Cantor, Amali Milson, Bonnie Mackey, Jake Isaias, Izair Abdullah, Max Zane, Will Smiley, and Carter K. Malhotra, who is overseas today. Our vice captains for 2022, Jackie Bashkan-Lugavadel, and Sam Priestap. And our school captains, Sophia Winters, and Ryan Basil. Can we please congratulate our athletes? We
would like to extend our sincere thanks to the Baulkham Hills North Public School community on behalf of the 2022 Student Leadership Team.
On behalf of Year 6, we would like to present a gift to the school for all of Year 6. Would Mr. Holmes and Ms. Carter please come forward to accept the gift of shinning cards for the senior playground that we hope you will all enjoy for the years to come. As our time comes to an end, as your school leaders, we would like to introduce your school leaders for 2023.
We have had the honour of being your leaders this year and invite Mr. Holmes and Mrs. Smith to announce the school leaders for 2023.
Female prefects, Amber Dawson, Isabel Lynn, Lucy Sherwood, Charlotte Lees, Sophie Kim, Alexandra Nielsen, Olivia Lee, Evie Toos. Our male prefects, Samuel Zhao, Hayden Wang, Devaya Maidu, Hayden Bailsmith, Eddie Chin, Ayan Wackus, who is away today, Flynn Scanlon, and Ethan Saunders.
Part of our leadership transition, we invite our current prefects to hand over the school blazers to our new leaders. Can we please congratulate our outgoing leadership team one final time? Now announce our bus captains and captains, school captains for 2023. So our vice captains for 2023 are Samuel Zhu and Isabel Lim. Our graduates for 2023, Devane Nadu and Amber Dawson. So I'll now invite our new captains and vice captains to run the remainder of this assembly.
As the leaders for 2023, and I know we have had great role models this year whose path we will follow. Congratulations to the outgoing leaders on an outstanding year as our leaders.
Congratulations to all of those students who have received awards today. We want to say a big thank you to you, special guests, for joining us today, and to the parents who have watched us via our live stream.
Please remain standing quietly as Jasmine and Samuel play the violin to accompany our special guest after that. We will now listen to the school song. A copy of the school song is on the program. Quietly stand.
To invite our special guests to leave our assembly first.